sometimes technology can advance so far, so quickly, that people have a hard time embracing it. But a professor at North Carolina State University has spent nearly 25 years perfecting a product that is just now gaining traction.
In this evening's Buckley Report, see what she's created and how it can save so many lives in both the military and civilian worlds.
It's always exciting to see the new material.
If you can call a material more than 20 years in the making new, then the stuff North Carolina State researcher Afsana Rabih created is the new thing that can revolutionize protective materials.
So the matrix provides the strength. The bubbles provide the insulation and protection.
She calls it composite metal foam, CMF. And when we first met her 15 years ago, she told us,
"This is a material for future, and I have no doubt about it."
The last time we met, you called this the material of the future.
Mm-hmm.
And I want to know if the future is now here.
It is. For a material like this to be so revolutionary, it takes time. It takes time to convince people to replace a heavy metal with a lightweight metal they don't trust. You know, are you sure?
You have the science to back it up.
We do.
3, 2, 1.
That science shows that CMF can withstand a blast bigger than most shells shot at troop transports.
It did not penetrate, it just deformed.
And can stop bullets bigger than the ones shot from 50 caliber machine guns.
And transferring over 17,000 joules of force on impact energy.
In the field of defense, the applications are endless.
And because it doesn't burn or transfer heat, Professor Rabih says it is ideal for transporting hazardous materials and could have prevented the tragedy that happened when a train derailed near East Palestine, Ohio in February of 2023, as well as prevented the Challenger space shuttle from exploding in January of 1986. And does all that with material that weighs about a third of what solid steel does. Was there anywhere in this process where you said this might not work?
Oh yeah. Oh yeah.
But after 20 years, the prototypes are made and the patents are on the wall.
I think we are at that tipping point right now with the company.
A tipping point that not only has the potential to make a lot of money, but also serve what Professor Rabih told us 10 years ago was her primary goal.
It's really my dream to be able to help people and protect their lives.
The woman who left Iran and came to Harvard as an immigrant student is now a proud American citizen who hopes to leave a legacy.
Famously, Alfred Nobel regretted inventing dynamite.
Mm-hmm.
You're kind of reversing that. At the end of the day, a big part of the reward is you're making the world safer.
Absolutely. I think that's a legacy that I would like to leave behind.
Bob Buckley, Fox 8 News.
Again, this product's called composite metal foam and goes by the name CMF. Professor Rabih's company that makes it is called Advanced Materials Manufacturing, and it is based in Raleigh.